FoodtokTV. Let's go! Welcome to The Spices Right. We're so glad to be here. Sorry for that little late start. I had to uninstall and reinstall TikTok because I kept getting that puzzle piece over and over and over, but even when I was in somebody else's life. So Mark called Taylor. Taylor got that checked out in like 3 seconds, and now we're going. So tonight, everyone, what I'm going to be making is a classic comfort food. I'm going to be making American goulash. Now, there are tons of goulashes, okay? There's Hungarian goulash. There is Midwestern goulash. There is, oh my gosh. I grew up eating macaroni delight, which was so delicious. But this is a true American goulash that I'm going to be making. And so it's ground beef, it's pasta, it's some onion, garlic, bell pepper. We're gonna put some cheese in it. Of course, a lot of tomatoes and noodles. And it is comfort food extraordinaire. So that's what we're gonna be doing tonight. I'm also gonna be making bag-o salad because, yeah, bag-o salad. It's all about the bag-o salad. So I'm gonna be doing that tonight too. And I asked Mark, I said, how about some garlic bread? He goes, nope, you know how I want this? I want it with just bread and butter. So we're gonna have bread and butter. It is Italian bread, but it is just bread and butter. So you don't have to make it complicated, guys. You could just have a great meal and the leftovers are even better. Mm-hmm. So here we go. Let's go, guys. You ready to start?
I'm ready. Welcome in, everybody, to Food Talk TV on a Monday night. The Spice is Right. Woo! Seeing a lot of our friends in here. So I see Maddie. Chelsea. Of course,
Maddie made my picadillo. I saw. He sent pictures. I love it. That's the biggest compliment in the world when somebody makes one of your recipes and shares it with you.
JDP's in here.
JDP! How you
doing? King ZY. See who else is
Look
in here.
Look at our friends. Yay, friends. I need to dance with some JDP. I got some rubber band man going on, JDP.
Oh, Sherry, how you doing? Welcome in to everyone. We appreciate y'all coming in tonight with us. Melissa is going to be making some American goulash tonight. And we're going to have a salad with that.
And some bread and butter, because that's what Mark wanted. I am making something for Mark. Mark doesn't ask for a lot. He eats what I usually feed him. But you know what? He asked me. I've had my own followers under Melissa Murd ask me, hey, can we make some goulash? I'm like, heck yeah, let's just do it on Food Talk. Why not?
Mm-hmm. So we had a quick question.
Sure.
Let's see. Mima Mary wanted to know where you got your cheese grater.
All right. Well, I got this off of, and now they've come out with some better ones. I'll be honest with you. A lot of times the cheese gets stuck in here. If you follow Mark Murd, that's my husband that you're hearing speak right now. We play games at night. And I'm going to be giving away my cheese grater that I've been using as a gift. I also have another one that I ordered by accident. That's not this. It's a little bit bigger, but it wasn't the big one that I really wanted. And so I'm going to have that for a giveaway. It's awesome, though. It was on the TikTok shop, but hold on. If you want to come play some games, trivia, math, science and math is my jam. Trivia is more Mark's jam and current events. We play afterwards, like around 7:30, because we have an after call with our leadership team at Food Talk TV, where they can tell me how I can do better, how we can do better collectively, and it's a great thing to know. So, if you want this, come play with us. You can even win this one. Hey, it's been good to me, but I have upgraded to the newest one out, and it shreds, it waffle cuts, ripple cuts, it does all kinds of stuff. This just grates.
All right, Sherry said, I just watched a couple other lives, and yours is the best.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you so much, Sherry.
She's so sweet. Okay, guys. What is this, guys? Those of you who follow me personally, this is liquid gold. This is called fat. It is piggle wiggle fat. Let's go.
Try.
I'm just going to add a little bit, guys, because I'm not trying to make this too terribly fatty, but I do like that pork flavor.
Chelsea said she's been wanting to make goulash. She's taking notes.
Let's go. So that was about a teaspoon. I'm going to add about a teaspoon of olive oil on top of that. And so we're bringing this all up to temperature. Mark, are you in the pan with me, baby?
I am in the pan.
All right. So we're bringing this up to temperature. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a pound of hamburger meat. Now, I just got through washing this pound of hamburger meat. And when I say wash it, I mean wash the container, right? Because, you know, people have been touching it. Oh, don't even get me started. I'm a nurse, guys. Those of you who don't know, I'm a nurse. Don't even make me want to throw up yet. All right, so here we go. So we're getting all this 80-20 in here. Yes, I use 80-20. Why do I use 80-20? Because it's good. It's good and moist. It's not too dry. But listen, for those of you that are concerned with fat, which a lot of people are because they have high cholesterol, high blood pressure, and all that kind of stuff, you could use ground turkey, you can use ground chicken.
Yep, good evening, Marie, and good evening, Trini. How are y'all? Good to see y'all.
Marie.
So, me and Mary asking about the grocery shed. She ordered mine the other day and lost the handle. Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Trini said she loves hers, and Maddie said he needs one of those cheese graters.
Come on, Maddie. You know, you come play games with us. There are going to be two cheese graters up. One is this one, because I just bought a new one. I haven't gotten it yet. And then I got one just today in the mail, and I ordered the wrong dadgum thing. So that's brand spanking new. This one's not brand spanking new. There ain't nothing wrong with this one. Plus, it's pretty.
Yeah, Candy Hurtado, thanks for coming in. Said if you spray some Pam on the metal part of the grater, the cheese won't stick as you shred it.
Really? What? Look at this, guys. Did you hear? Look at this. Glug, glug, glug. For those of you who follow, you know. So let me unstick it, and I'm going to do it.
Let's do it. Hey, Carol, Texas. Good evening. Good to see you.
Oh, hello. Glug, glug, glug. That was no glug. That was just...
Welcome in, everybody, to Food Talk TV tonight, Monday night. Our program, The Spice is Right, with Melissa. She is making goulash tonight. And if some of you are just scrolling through, Food Talk TV is the longest running live cooking show on TikTok.
It is. All right, so all I'm doing, guys, you're seeing it in my pan, right?
Yes.
So I don't have to lift it.
Absolutely.
Okay. So all I'm doing, guys, is just using this really cool thing. You can get it on Amazon. It's just a cheese, or you can probably get it on the TikTok shop. It's just a, not cheese, it is a beef grinder, stir, chopper, whatever you want to call it.
Hey, Bobette Summer Woods, thank you for coming in. Thank you for the follow. We appreciate that. Good evening, Andrea. How are you?
Is that I see you?
I see you.
I see you.
I see you too.
I see you and Lulu. Hey, Mama don't want you and Daddy don't want you.
Kingsy Y has a great question. Is there a way I can like request a dish to be made? I have a dish recommendation. There sure is, King ZY.
Tell them all about it.
Yep. You can go to King ZY, cookthisforme.com. It's cook, C-O-O-K, this, T-H-I-S, the number four, me. Cookthisforme.com, and you can go on there and request anything you would like to see Melissa
anybody
make, or any of the creators on Food Talk TV for that matter. So absolutely, any of y'all can do that if you would like to see a particular dish made. You betcha. Thank you for asking that.
And you can definitely share a recipe. We'd love it.
Absolutely.
And you'll get a call out. All right, guys, I'm just doing some mince on this onion. Sorry, I'm loving this song. Mama don't want
you. Hey, yeah, good evening, Brittany. Thank you for the follow. We appreciate that. So thank you all for being here tonight. Don't
JDP, I hope you're dancing with me. Ooh, Daddy don't want you.
Hey, Mama Mary, how are you? Making spaghetti? She's on that Italian theme.
Let's go. Yo, guys, get up and dance. Listen, it's taken everything in the world for me not to be dancing all over this kitchen right now.
Good evening to you also, Kay Dot. Thank you for the follow. We appreciate that. Thank you for all the new follows tonight. Thank y'all for all the likes so far. Let's be sure and keep tapping the screen, everybody. We appreciate it. And thank you for all the likes. I've been seeing y'all do a lot of sharing as well. Thank y'all so much for that.
Now here's the controversy, guys. You definitely can use garlic or you can use garlic. If you have time to use garlic, I would highly recommend you using garlic. If you don't have time, there ain't no shame in anybody's game using garlic. Did you hear me? Did you hear me, Benjamin? There ain't no shame in using garlic if that's what you need. And you know what he said? He did tell me. He said, you know what? Absolutely. You got to do what's best for you and your family. Yeah, I just got off work probably about 30 minutes ago. And I'm able to use fresh garlic, so I'm going to do it.
Hey, Carly, how are you? Good evening to you, and good evening. This is a different Rick. Hello, Rick. Said hello, friends. And Barbara Budlong had a good dinner last night. She had beef tongue amongst some several sides.
Yes. And butter rolls. Linguine. Mm-hmm.
Nothing wrong with that, King. I love pizza.
For real,
Z. And thank you guys for all the gifts. Thank you, Curly, for the Give Me the Boat.
Thank you, Curly.
JPD gave some chilies earlier. Thank you for those as well. So Marie said, do you think fresh is better than the powdered garlic?
No, I'm going to add powder too. I absolutely do not. I just think that anytime I can use fresh, I like to use fresh because I came from farmers and I like to support farmers. And you can't get powder without using fresh, right? Fresh.
Good point.
So it's all the same thing. It's just in dehydrated form. So I'm not going to be, yeah. So.
Hey, Pam, good evening. How you doing? Kelsey's making buffalo chicken dip.
Yum.
And Kyle. Well, good evening, Kyle. How are you?
Hey, Kyle.
To see all of our regular friends and followers and everybody that's new to the channel. You're watching Food Talk TV. If you're just scrolling through and you're watching Melissa here make goulash tonight.
American goulash. Yes. There's all kinds of goulash, guys. Depends on what region you're in. Plus, there's Hungarian goulash. There's all kinds of goulash. This is just the one that Mark loves so much that I make. And he asked me to make this. You know what I said? I'm like, Dad, gummit. What do you mean? You don't want any coconut tonight? He's like, no, I've had enough coconut. That's from our challenge that we had the other night.
So we have our regular Rick in here, and then we also have Rick with a K.
Rick
with a K said, I can smell it from here.
Ooh, it smells so good.
It does. Hey, Kim, how are you? Good to see you, Kim Bond.
Hey. All right, guys, let me do a real quick 10-second cooking school, if you don't mind. So 10-second cooking school, to get indigestion, those people that have indigestion, like Mark, when they eat bell peppers, if you remove this white, all of this white, just that simple, make sure you get the white out, all of it, and make sure you get the seeds out, he won't have indigestion, and neither will you. 10-second cooking school.
And I can attest, it does work. Because it used to give me fits and meatloaf, and she does that now, and it does not.
There is no white left. That's the membrane, guys. So those of you who like know how it is to cook with peppers and jalapenos and stuff, so as long as you take all that membrane out, he'll eat it all day long, no problem. Because the flavor, guys, you know the flavor is excellent.
So Barbara Budlong. Question for you. Are you a chef, or with all that delicious food you had last night? Hey, Maria, how are you?
Oh, my goodness, my sweet friend.
Yes, Maria.
I have been thinking about you and Mark and the babies. I've been thinking about Mama. Yep. I've been thinking about Mavis.
Of course, Sherry's in here, too, as well,
yes,
right in the,
guys,
the path.
Riding
so.
The hurricane.
Yep, so
and that hurricane's not playing.
No, it's not. So thoughts in
y'all need a place to come. Texas is always here for you, right here.
Absolutely.
And then y'all can leave Mavis here for Truett. We've already discussed that.
Marisa, it looks delicious, and thank you for telling us. So hey, Rachel, how are you? Good to see you. Thank you for the heart, and Rachel.
Thank you. Thank you so much, guys.
I know, Maria. I was reading about it today. 100 and
60, I think.
Yeah,
we saw
160
last.
Saw last. She said 180 now, apparently.
Oh my gosh.
So, and took just a few hours to go from a cat 2 to a cat 5. So, yeah, like I said, it's not kidding around. So, everybody's thoughts are with y'all there.
Very much. Guys, just want to let you know that you can triple this recipe. I'm just making this for Mark and I. I will probably end up freezing some. This absolutely is a great dish to freeze.
Yeah, like I said, it's one of those that tastes better sometimes.
It actually does. It's like spaghetti or lasagna. It tastes better the next day, but I'm pretty sure he's not going to be pushing away from the table.
No. So Barbara said she cooks and bakes and everything from scratch.
Yes, let's go. Good for you. That's awesome.
Hey, and welcome in, Yasmin. How you doing? Cook with Yasmin's
hey,
in the
Yasmin,
house.
How are you
doing?
You?
Good to see you. Good to see everybody tonight on Monday night. Our show, The Spice is Right, every Monday at 6 p.m. Central with Melissa. And like we said, she is cooking American goulash tonight. That recipe should already be on the FoodtokTV.com website. You can get that and many other recipes from our awesome creators, which are on daily.
That's a half a teaspoon of beef bouillon, guys. This is the brand I use. Any brand will work, but you gotta really watch the salt. You gotta watch the salt, guys. You gotta make sure it's not over salty. I'm just bringing some water up to boil. I'm gonna add, what I did is used a half a teaspoon because 1 teaspoon of that makes 1 cup of broth. Well, I only need a half a cup of broth.
I got some Teresa in here. Hey, Teresa.
Hey,
and
hey,
and another tea, Tatiana. Hey, Tatiana, how are you?
Hi, y'all.
Thank you for the heart me.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Guys, if you're not following Food Talk TV, you should. We have creators on every day, sometimes multiple times a day. We're always bringing on new creators. We also have Grub Bash going on every Saturday.
That's
and
right.
And then next Sunday night, we're starting a new theme week. I'm so excited. We've got a new creator starting Thursday at 12 noon. His name's Benjamin. That's Central Standard Time. His name's Benjamin. I'm so excited.
Yeah,
I'm
you should
so
be
excited.
Popping
chopping
in here
it
in the
up.
Next little bit
yeah,
just to say hello.
Up.
So, yeah, Rachel, you might want to go out and come back in. We're not having any issues on our end as far as lagging. So Barbara said when she first got married, she couldn't boil water, but she learned.
Yeah, I
sounds familiar, huh?
Listen, I couldn't wash dishes in the dishwasher. I flooded my apartment with bubbles. Oh, like Trini just did.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, yeah. Elsa, did you hear that,
yes.
Trini?
That's
Trini,
hilarious.
Alexa goes, I'm not quite sure how to help you with that. That was cute.
That was awesome. Hey, good evening, Cannon Kitchen. Thanks for coming in and for the chilies. We appreciate that. And let's go TikTok. Welcome in. Said family, keep tapping the screen and share the light.
Let's go. So guys, you can see I don't have a lot of grease in here, if any. It's just really not bad at all. And that was with a little bit of piggy wiggy fat and just a couple of bits of extra virgin olive oil. And this is 80-20. And people will honestly tell you, why are you using 80-20? It's so fat. I'm sorry, I'm not seeing it. And I added extra fat.
Yeah, it's not at all.
Yeah,
so.
It's just fine. All right, so I am fixing to put, I don't know if y'all saw that. I just washed the can lid off. Y'all make sure to do that, okay? I'm a nurse, so I always think of like microscopic disgustedness. So make sure you do that.
Yeah, Mima Kim, this is American goulash that Melissa's making tonight.
This is 1 can, 15 ounce tomato stock or tomato sauce. Now, I know that looks like a lot of liquid, guys, and honestly, it is a lot of liquid, but we are going to be cooking our pasta in here. So we're not going to be boiling pasta separately.
Barbara, thank you so much for the follow. We appreciate that very much, and all the other new followers. Hopefully you heard me a minute ago. Let's go TikTok. We have American goulash that Melissa's making tonight. Also, Cindy, welcome in.
Welcome,
as well.
Guys.
Thank you, everyone, for being here. We appreciate all your time and presence here. And appreciate you spending some time with us here on Food Talk TV tonight. we are not on just Monday nights. Food Talk TV has creators on 7 days a week, most times multiple times a day.
We're so glad y'all are here. All right, guys, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a 14.5 ounce can of stewed tomatoes. You can just use peeled tomatoes. If you want to cut up your own tomatoes, you can do that too, I imagine. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it down here a little bit in the pan and just do a little crushy McCrush crush. How's that? Be careful, don't cut your hands on the lids. I tend to cut my hands on the lids of stuff, and it really upsets me because, boy, does it hurt. If I cut my finger off here in my kitchen, I'd never feel it. I'd just look down and go, hey, oh, I got you, Mark. I would be going, what is that tomato sauce? I didn't cook with tomato sauce, and I look down, and then I don't have a finger. That's how sharp I keep my knives.
It's all that power you got in your fingers there.
Yeah.
Got across here, so.
Let's
absolutely
go.
So Yola, thank you for coming in tonight to Food Talk TV. Thank you so much for the follow as well. Barbara said she actually likes Hungarian goulash.
Yes, isn't it the best? It is. Well, I like American too. So Mark asked for American goulash, but I do love Hungarian goulash as well. Very good.
Hey, good evening, Rhonda, a.k.a. Nana. Thank you as well for the follow. And hey, good evening, Cass. How are you?
Hey, Cass.
Thank you for the donuts. Appreciate that very much. Great to see you as always.
We're going to put 1.5 teaspoons of Italian seasoning in here.
Maddie asks, what's a hot dog in the dish?
What's a hot dog?
I don't know.
What's a hot dog? There ain't no hot dog in the dish.
So.
All right, so we're gonna put 1.5 teaspoons of Italian seasoning.
Oh, I see, your finger.
Oh, yeah, that is a hot dog.
I got it now, okay, took me a second. Sean, Mr. Bethel said just extra protein.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, Sherry. Said I'm so glad to be here. We're glad you
are
here,
Sherry,
as well
here.
As everybody else.
We're having a good time
That's
tonight.
Right.
We're making a good home-cooked meal. Mark said, Melissa, can we cook? It's like my friend Art, Squad of Cooks. She's a creator on Monday. She's my Monday partner. She makes beautiful food, beautiful platings, beautiful cocktails. And she does that on Mondays on Food Talk TV. And she goes that her sweet fiance goes, you always cook for Food Talk TV. I need you to cook for me. And Mark goes, you know, you cook for me all the time, but you know what? I'd really appreciate you making some goulash. I'm like, you know what? I think we can do that. So here we are. Now I'm going to add 1.5 teaspoons of dried basil. I always want to recommend, hey, if you can get fresh basil, yeah. But I would put that in, guys, at the end because basil's so delicate. I'm going to go ahead and just put a half of this teaspoon in there just not to have them. There we go.
And thank you for the follow, Portia B&M. Thank you. Yes, Kaz, thank you for mentioning that. Yes, we had another grab match this last Saturday night.
We did. Guys, go vote.
Mr. Cran Royal and Trini Cook. So please go to grubmatch.tv. I don't know if that's still up.
Go to FoodtokTV.
FoodtokTV.com.
I would go to FoodTok because I guarantee you'll get to see.
Yeah, you can get in there for sure.
One bay leaf.
And it is FoodtokTV.com.
One bay leaf and then a itsy bitsy bay leaf because it's supposed to be 1.5. Make sure you guys take that out though before you serve it because you don't want anybody choking to death at your table because that is not cute.
Oh, thank you, Trini. She had a great life. Melissa?
Thank you, Trini.
Hey, friend. How are you? Good to see you. Thank you for give me the vote.
Friend.
And Kathleen Roy, thank you so much for the follow. We appreciate that as well. But, yeah, voting will be up until Saturday morning at 10 p.m. Central, I believe. And, y'all please go in and vote.
1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce.
Because you, the followers, get to choose who wins. So it's very important that you vote.
Quarter teaspoon of some salt. Honey, can you open that for me, please?
I can't.
Right here, this part.
Does it just pop up?
Yeah. There you go. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Okay, so we're going to put a quarter teaspoon of salt in.
And speaking of Garot Match, there is Sasha Hurtado.
Sasha,
Mrs. Crown Royal's spouse and... she saw firsthand what Mr. Crown Royal made, so.
Delicious, that cooked with cinnamon, and it was so spectacular.
Yes, and they are on Friday nights on Food Talk TV at 6:30 p.m. Central. Jesse
Quarter
does a lot of
teaspoon onion powder.
Jesse does a lot of grilling, and they are fantastic. They're our fellow Texans. We are located just right outside of Austin. For those of y'all who might be new to us.
Quarter teaspoon of garlic powder, and y'all saw that I put fresh garlic in it and fresh onion, but I like to just like accentuate it just a little bit.
Oh, thank you, Kaz. He said, congrats to Melissa, our first winner.
Oh, thank you, Kaz. All right, so now we're going to add just to my liking, because I already did put onion and onion powder. I'm just going to add a little bit of dried minced onion.
Yeah, we appreciate everybody out there that did vote during the first scrub match. And again, please go and vote on this one as well. And we'll have another one this Friday or this Saturday night.
Yeah, so excited. It's going to be Taylor, the Mustard Queen. That is the general manager of FoodtokTV. And she's going to be taking on Mama T. Mm-hmm. And they're making potatoes. All right, fresh cracked pepper, guys. If you guys haven't heard me say anything in the whole wide world, listen to this. If you can use fresh cracked pepper, use it.
All right, we have Father Pernier in here, Benjamin.
Benjamin,
let
what's
me
up?
Invite you
let
in,
me,
Benjamin.
Let me turn down my music just a tad so we can hear you talk, Benjamin.
Yes,
we're
going to
keep that at 5 minutes, Benjamin, right? So, because I'll be moving on to my salad. Welcome in, Benjamin. Did you invite him?
I'm fixing to. So I was reading a comment here. Chelsea Lane, welcome in. Should I love your stove? What brand is it? She's probably talking about the induction burner.
This is from Cuisinart or Tasty. I'm not sure. I think they're both one of the same now. I'm not sure. But there are so many brands of induction that, I mean, like, I'm in love with Taylor's induction. I'm in love with Kaz's induction. I mean, I can't even pick anymore.
There he is. Our newest FoodtokTV creator. Welcome in, Benjamin.
Congratulations. Welcome in.
Yeah, introduce yourself and let everybody know a little bit about you, when your show is going to be and what it's going to be about.
Okay, yeah. My name is Benjamin, a.k.a. Father Preneur. The reason why my name is Father Preneur, first things at first, I am not a priest, but I get that asked every now and then. I am a father, and I'm also an entrepreneur, so I combined both words together. I come with the background of food and beverage. I am not a chef, never will say I'm a chef. I was in the hospitality industry for over 20 years, all food and beverage. The last 15 years of that industry I was in, I was a director of food and beverage at a lot of resorts and country clubs. And that position, it revolves around you being in charge of everything regarding the whole operation. So I oversaw chefs, managers. Being in a position like that, you kind of got to be aware of all the aspects of food and beverage. You don't got to be the best at everything. You just got to be aware of it and understand it, especially if you're going to tell the chef, hey, this dish is wrong. You better know what you're talking about. So that's kind of where my background comes from. I enjoy cooking for my family, for people I love. I always like to test out recipes and mess around in my kitchen. I've been going live on TikTok for quite a bit of while. I do it about 5 to 6 times a week. And I'm just – a lot of times my cooking style – my daily lives is using stuff that I already have in my house, because I'm a big component on not having anything go to waste. Me and Melissa are very similar. We like to save as much as we can and reuse it, from as much as saving stems of herbs or bits and pieces of garlic and onions and reusing it for stock, and always doing the best that you can to reuse things and just make sure you can get your best bang for your buck when it comes to your money.
For real.
Oh, thank you, JDP and Tatiana. So I'm excited about this. So every Thursday, I will be doing my cooking show at 12 p.m. Central Time. And, you know, the goal is to be able to provide things that I can provide a cooking style that is stuff that you can do in your house. It can be simple as providing food for your family, your kids, or your hot date. It will always change a little bit, and I'm excited for it. And I know that I really want to cook with pumpkin. So this Thursday, I'm going to be doing something with pumpkin. When I go to the grocery stores right now, I see a lot of pumpkins everywhere. So I figured that'd be a good way to start off with my live. And then also me and Taylor, since we both come from a background of food and beverage and her being in the bar industry, you know, we thought we would do also a playoff of Thursdays and call it Thirsty Thursdays between the two of us, or maybe each of us will feature a cocktail every Thursday.
Oh, that's so cute.
So yeah, so we're gonna be trying to work out whip out a cocktail in the show itself for each my show and her show. So I'm very excited. I'm very humbled to be part of this. And I want to also thank Melissa because she's the one that kind of stumbled upon my live one day about 2 months ago. And since then, we've talked to each other a lot. We've talked and we've even competed against each other. And she's put me in talks with Taylor.
I love him.
So I appreciate you giving me this time. I know you're making your American goulash. So I'm going to step down and I appreciate you and have a great show, Melissa. Yep. And thank you, Mark.
Melissa and Benjamin have become great TikTok friends.
Oh my God. I absolutely adore
We are very excited, I know, the whole Food Talk TV family to have Benjamin in now. And we're excited about your show Thursday, Benjamin. And we're going to look forward to that, seeing you every Thursday. And if any of you in here, if you're not following Cooking with Fatherpreneur, please give him a follow personally because he does go live also many days of the week.
Yeah, he does. I love him. And what's so great, what I really love, and this wasn't planned. Oh, listen, I got to make sure this isn't poisonous. No, it's not poisonous. It works.
You need a second opinion?
I'm going to try it when it's cooked. So, but yeah, we appreciate you coming in, Benjamin. We appreciate you.
Have a good evening.
Thank you. You too. Thank you so much for coming in. So, thank you, everybody. Hey, Janine, how are you? Good to see you. Janine Scott is in the house.
Yeah, me.
Awesome. Yeah, I like that Thirsty Thursdays.
I love that.
And I saw McWizzle and JDP in there lighting up Benjamin's box. That's also awesome.
These are all friends that I have made, I was blessed to make when I stumbled upon Benjamin when I was just... Guys, how many times do we like TikTok scroll with stuff? I was at lunch. I don't know that Mark was home. He may have been at a doctor's appointment or running errands or something. And I was just like, I love this man. I love him. Then I start following his followers and I'm like, wow, what a blessing. JDP, fabulous cook. Oh my goodness. It's amazing how we just cross others' paths.
Yep, and Food Talk TV is getting more and more great creators, and if anybody else out there might be interested, you can go to the bio. There's a link down at the bottom of the bio, and you can actually send an audition tape. The grub matches also are ways now that Food Talk TV is looking at creators as well, so absolutely.
And Trini was just brought on through that. I think she did a wonderful job. She took on Mr. Crown Royal. They did cinnamon. That's not an easy ingredient, I'll tell you that. That wasn't easy. Great creativity that I saw from both. Mm-hmm. Mr. Crown, Jesse, and from Trini. It was a fabulous live.
Yeah, let me also welcome Carrie Johnson and KK, new followers. Thank y'all so much for the follows. We appreciate it. And Kelso Girl.
Hello, Kelso Girl.
Thank you for the heart me and Vicky White Brewers in here as well. Hey, good to see you, Vicky.
How are you, friend? Welcome in. Happy Monday night to everyone.
Yes, thank y'all so much for spending time with us tonight.
We are blessed with your presence.
The spice is right. Melissa is making goulash. That's what we have going right here in the pot. So American goulash, to be specific.
Every Monday night, you will find me here on Food Talk TV. Come anything, as long as I have the capability. We may have to do it by candlelight, whatever. But as long as I can do it, I have a gas oven, so that shouldn't be an issue. That will not be an excuse.
Oh, Pam said she's making this tonight for Carl, as a matter of fact.
Yay!
So that's awesome.
You can't beat it. I'm not quite sure that
wasn't
poisonous.
Hey, Liliana, how are you? Thank you for coming in tonight. We're doing great. Thank you.
Definitely not poisonous.
Excellent. So I want to make sure once it's cooked, then I'll confirm.
Yeah.
Yes, that is true, Kaz. He said next week will be interesting. He wants to see what they're going to do with potato.
I know. I can't even imagine. Just such a beautiful blank canvas.
And Taylor already told us a minute ago before we went on. She said, it's going to blow your mind, my menu. So we are looking forward to that. And that'll be Saturday night at 6 p.m. Central.
Yes, and Mama T is one of my buddies, and she can cook. Ooh, she can cook. I was really hoping she was going to be able to take on bacon.
Yes, and the grub matches are friendly competitions,
it
mind you, but
very
the
friendly.
But the competition, they
it
take it seriously.
Yeah.
So no doubt. So it's a lot of fun. Oh, you're not making it tonight, Pam? Oh, he's still on his crazy schedule, I guess.
Oh. Huh?
So thank you, lovely Anna, for the heart, me, and for joining the team.
Thank you, guys. Also, Mark, would you like to talk to them about my channel?
Absolutely. If y'all aren't following Melissa, her channel is Melissa Murd, MelissaMurd. We go on her channel usually on Wednesday nights, Friday nights, and Saturday and or Sunday.
Yeah, we took yesterday off.
Yes, and usually she will cook. She does here on FoodtokTV, and then we'll sit down and eat, chat with everybody, and then we actually go to my channel.
Mark Murd.
Do some trivia, and we have monthly giveaways.
It's so fun, guys. It really is fun.
No, thank you, Taylor, for pinning that. So she pinned your TikTok username. So thank you, Taylor. Trine said she is anxious to watch the potato match.
I know. It's going to be something to watch. I can only imagine the creativity that's going to come out of this.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So good evening, Rosie. How are you? Thank you for coming in. So we welcome everybody in tonight on our Monday night show, The Spice is Right. So Melissa is making goulash tonight, and of course she's making a salad right now. And I love egg in my salad.
Yeah, I don't. Unless it's egg salad, don't put egg in my salad.
Hey Rita, how are you? Good evening, nice to see you, Rita.
Hi Rita,
so,
welcome in.
Remember everybody, please keep tapping the screen. Remember, tapping's clapping.
That's right.
Give Melissa some applause and love and support.
Not talking stalkers, y'all. Don't be stalkers up in here.
That's right. And also be sure to keep sharing the live. We appreciate all those likes and shares. And thank you all for the gifts as well. Those are much appreciated too by FoodtokTV.
10-second cooking school. When you have one of these cheese graters, whether it's the newest and the greatest, which is coming, this is one of the older brands. I got a yellow one like Kaz just because I'm a copycat. You know, that's how I roll. Don't wash it in hot water. Do cold water, because if you wash this in hot water, the cheese is just going to melt and it's going to be a mess. 10-second cooking school.
Yes, Mark found that out the hard way because he didn't know any better. And he had a mess.
He had a mess.
Worse than the coconut mess.
Oh my gosh. I'm still seeing coconut. All right, I'm putting all this in the bottom of the bowl. This is just one egg. Got a half of a Roma tomato, seedless.
Liliana, main dish tonight is goulash, American goulash, and it is on the induction burner right now. Of course, Melissa's making a salad currently, but the goulash is over here. We're going to look at that shortly. So,
all right. Now, another thing you might want to do, 10-second cooking school. When making a salad, you don't want to salt your salad, pepper your salad, season your salad on the top. You want to do it in the bottom. So just like putting in this wet ingredient. So tomatoes, eggs are kind of considered wet. You want to toss it and then you bring up all that. Fresh cracked pepper, nothing else but fresh cracked pepper in your salad. Ever, never. I like fresh grated salt also, but I don't have a salt grater. So this is just pink Himalayan salt.
Hey, Melissa.
Hey.
Not Michelle, Melissa. Sorry. Good evening, Michelle.
Hi, Michelle.
So, get my M's mixed up. Yes, you're Michelle, Red Wagon Bakery.
Hi, Michelle.
Michelle, Red Wagon Bakery. She is another awesome creator on FoodtokTV. And she does have a, actually, baking business. Her and her husband, Paul, they're awesome. They are on bright and early Wednesday morning, 7 a.m. Central.
They are. You guys got to go check them out. And then Andrea comes on right after them, I think at 10 o'clock Central, right?
Or 9.
9 o'clock
yes.
Central, yes. And she's gluten-free mom. I'm
yes.
telling you, the two of them got it going on. Wake up Wednesday. Let's go.
That's right. Thank you, Safety24BBJ, for the follow. Appreciate that. Yeah, and Michelle and Paul make some awesome breakfasts. I was looking at the apple turnovers again today on Facebook. I ran across them again. It's like, oh, man. So, hey, Eating with Andrew. Good to see you.
How you doing? Andrew, how are you and your pumpers, my sweet friend?
Andrew lives up in the mountains of Colorado. Beautiful,
beautiful
area he lives
there.
In. Oh, thank you, Michelle. We love you and Paul, too. And we appreciate everything for all you do as well. Marie said it looks delicious.
Thank you. Bye-bye, baby. No choking at my house.
Right, Michelle? Good point. She said we do all the gluten. She does the gluten-free.
Bye-bye, baby. So both babies are out. This is a really good time, guys, because my noodles are now cooked. This is a really good time, guys, to taste for salt or whatever seasoning you need.
So our Rick said, y'all know you need cornbread with that.
I know, but you know what my husband asked for? I said, Mark, I'm going to do garlic bread. He goes, oh, no, I want just bread with butter. That's what he's going to get. That's what my man wants. I cook for my man.
That's right. I can dip that bread in there, too.
That's what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. Pam said, oh, my, that looks delicious.
Thank you.
You ought to just, I know it's going to be delicious, but just the smell alone is making me hungrier and hungrier.
Well, that's good. So, guys, I'm going to add a little bit of this deluxe American. If you guys don't have American, you can use whatever you want. You mustard, good, pepper jack. But I love these slices. This is back from the day. Let me turn this down a little bit. That's from the back in the day, you know, craft singles and all that stuff. And again, let me taste for poison. Just a minute, I'm gonna have to chew that for a minute. Guys, I am gonna add, just to tell y'all right now, I am gonna add just a little bit more salt. Although that American cheese, you guys know American cheese adds salt, right? So I'm not gonna add too much.
Miss Shan said, save her some. Mm-hmm. And Michelle said that's how we ate it too, bread and butter.
Yep.
Nikki said looks amazing.
Thank you guys. Y'all are so kind. I appreciate you.
Oh, thank you, Michelle. She said yours looks so much better than her mom's did, though.
Oh, well, thank you, Mark. Look away. Hello! A little bit of hot sauce in there, boys and boils.
All right. I saw that.
You won't taste
no,
it.
No, I know.
It just gives it a little bit of vinegar. You could add vinegar.
That's true. Hey, welcome in, Catherine. Ooh, Arnold. That is HLT. American goulash.
That is good, what that is, ladies and gentlemen.
It is good American goulash.
All right, this is, in my opinion, almost done. Let me throw this salad together. My favorite thing to do is bag old salad. I love bag old salad. And this evening, tonight, is chopped salad kit by Market Side. And it is avocado ranch. It has green cabbage, green leaf lettuce, kale, red cabbage, carrots, green onions, four cheese blend, blue corn tortilla strips with avocado ranch dressing. What's not too love?
And I know in Asia with some of these dressings, you can't find them anywhere but in these little kits. And some of those dressings are awesome, though. Yes, Rick, that was Louisiana, not Texas Pete.
No, it wasn't Texas Pete. I like to use Louisiana a lot. I do have Texas Pete. Listen, guys, I could give you a tour of my hot sauce, but yeah, it's ridiculous. It is totally ridiculous.
King ZY said, looking great.
Thank you.
Thumbs up.
Thank you. All right, guys. Now, this could have been in a bigger bowl. I messed that up. That's me. That's on me.
Pam said, yep, that's the best flavor one.
All right, I'm tossing this on my own. I am using the world's best tongs in the world. That would be my hands. And no, guys, this is a cutting board. This is not my counter. I know I got a lot of people always ask me about that. No, I'm not cutting on my counter. I'm cutting on a cutting board. It's just clear. It's in my showcase. If you would like one, go and grab it.
Yeah, Christine was showing hers last night, so I think she was getting the same questions.
Yep, nope. Y'all go and grab it. You want it, y'all go grab it. I got it in my showcase. Let's go.
Yep. Hey, Carrie, Queen G.
How
are you? Good to see you. She said, this is my favorite kind of comfort food.
Oh, thanks, Queen.
Good to see you, Queen G. Her and her husband, Jeff, of course, are food creators also.
We're going to go see She and Trini.
Yes.
Uh-huh. At the beginning of November, and we are going to do a three-way collab. The girls cook one night, and the boys cook one night. how fun. We'll put events, guys, on Melissa Murd and Trini Home Cooks and then Queen G. We will put that up so people will be able to find us because we are going to have just a blast.
Yeah, I'll be fun. So Melissa has come up with the idea that us guys need to wear wigs.
Yeah, they all need to share Jeff's wigs. I think that would be hilarious. I told Mark, or you could wear your hair and call it a wig. Mark still has his hair, which is lovely. All right, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some of this American cheese on here. My ex-husband, wonderful man that he was, liked American cheese on his. So there we go. That's what we're doing. Let's just take care of everybody here. So all I know is it is not poisonous. I have tried it, and yet I'm going to try it again.
Carrie said it's going to be an all-weekend party. Rick said, I'm putting sunshine up for the winter.
What?
The W-I-N-N-E-R, not the winter, the winter.
No, sunshine comes here.
Right. Hey, good evening, Becky Perdue. How are you? Good
Becky,
to see you.
What's up, Becky?
Fatherpreneur was in here a little bit earlier introducing himself.
He was. Welcome in, Becky.
Great to see you. Thank you, everybody, for being here tonight with us on this awesome Monday night.
A little bit more Italian seasoning just so it looks kind of pretty. Not really, but who cares? I don't care how it looks. It's just going to be good.
That's right. You're not going to see it when it goes down.
No. Well, you do see it when it comes out. It won't be speckled, I hope.
Becky said, this is my kind of food. Trini said, John said he's down for the wig.
Let's go. All right, let me cover this up real quick, guys. It is in its last few minutes. It's steaming down.
You know, just to be with the guys, the in crowd, I could shave mine before we go and then...
That's a gnar. I love this man's hair. You know how I get his attention? He may not be listening to me, so I just go behind him and just yank that hair.
Oh, Pam, have a great night.
Good
great
night,
to see you as
Pam.
Always. Thank you so much.
Good night, sweet Pammy. All right, let's get ready to plate this bad boy.
Yeah, Rick said sunshine is moping since he left Rita's.
Aw. All right.
Mm-hmm. This is going to be just, can't wait.
I'm so excited that you're excited.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there you go, Carrie. We should get Mark a ball cap. Well, like I said, I'll go one better than just.
No, you won't. I'm sorry. I love his hair. I love bald, too, but I really love his hair. All right, so here's our lovely salad, right? And so it has all that cabbage and kale in it and tomato and bell pepper. I put some bacon in there for Mark. We've got some avocado ranch to go on that as well. Remember, you guys do not want to... Let me taste this. I gotta make sure this isn't poisonous too. Oh my gosh, that is fabulous. Yeah. Don't poison anybody, guys, whether you're a guy or a girl. Taste your food. No poisoning. Poisoning is not okay.
Remember, everybody, please keep tapping. I'm not seeing any hearts going up there.
What the heck?
We appreciate all the taps tonight. Remember, tapping's clapping.
Mm-hmm. I'm not talking stalking. Let's go.
That's right. So we appreciate all the likes, all the shares.
All right.
You guys are awesome. We appreciate y'all's company and presence.
Now, Mark wanted, I buy Italian bread. Mark wanted a slice of bread with butter with this, like there's not enough carbs in the pan. But he's going to get what he wants because that's the kind of chicky poo I am.
I could eat 5 or 6 pieces of bread with this.
Well. We're going to try to hold off on that because that's kind of what happened to you, isn't it? That's kind of what happened.
Yes, Coastal Girl, there will be between probably by 7:30, 7:45.
Yes, I would say 7:30 because I don't think Taylor's going to keep us on very long.
Yeah, so we will definitely be doing some trivia on my channel.
Trivia and math. Y'all bring your math caps. And your science caps. You know, if Mama's playing, we're going to be talking science and math. Science and math.
Hey, Savage. Savage said no timpin' pimpin'.
Hey, Savage.
Hey,
how are you?
There's October Dragonfly.
Hey, guys. You got to try the butter. Okay, that's not poisonous either. All right.
Melissa's been sampling everything tonight.
Yeah, nobody be telling me I don't eat, because have you seen this? Is any part of this look like I am malnourished?
There is Christine, yeah. October Dragonfly from Food Talk TV,
yes.
Sunday Night Live.
Yes!
I saw those, I was able to go in and out last night, Christine. Saw those little ghosts you did. Those were awesome.
Those were totally cute. What does anybody think about my American goulash? Does that look beautiful?
Looks good enough to eat.
Beautiful! There's a little bit of grease on top, and that's okay, because I'm just saying, who cares? I consider that gravy. Right.
And Christine just shared a light with 10 friends.
Oh my goodness, Christine, thank you.
Actually, more than 10 friends. Let me correct myself there. And thank you, Becky, for the heart me and joining the team. Thank you so much.
Oh boy.
What?
Mark, I gotta tell you, this looks pretty tasty. All right, so here we go. And I know exactly what he's gonna do. He's gonna be dipping his bread into the goulash.
Becky said, I'll have seconds, please. And yes. Kelsey Girl said, OMG, my mouth is watering. Father Premier, great job.
Seconds. Thank you.
Hey, Jacqueline, she said, yummy.
We've got plenty here, guys. Plenty, y'all come on. That's what I said on my bio. Y'all come on in here and pull yourself up a seat to our kitchen table.
Mm-hmm. Christine, October Dragonfly said delicious.
Thank you, guys. Y'all are so sweet.
Oh, hey, good evening, April/Ida. Thank you for coming in. She said, my son's a mad genius.
So let's go.
Yeah, and thank you for joining the team for the heart me.
All right, Mark, may I have your phone?
You may, or I can pop over there. Matter of fact, let me get my bearings here. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, we didn't show everybody our little new retro microwave. Melissa is very proud of this. We just got this today.
Look how little it is. It's a widow. But you know what, guys? It fits a full-size 10-inch dinner plate, okay? This thing cost me, like, what, $69, $79 bucks?
Yeah.
Yeah. And look at the color. It's like UT orange almost.
It had all kinds of cool colors.
Yeah, because let me show you my most expensive bread box.
Yes.
We bought this house brand new 5 years ago. Look what this says. Not for built installation. It stopped working. What the F word is this? Mark, show it. Is this built in, people?
It is built in.
So Mark's taking them on.
It is built in.
He's taking them on. I'm like, no, we're seniors. You guys are taking advantage of us. And that's where it's great to be a senior, because you cannot be taking advantage of senior citizens.
It is orange, Taylor. It's actually more of a Tennessee. University of Tennessee orange, actually.
I cannot even believe you said that.
Well, I mean, it is, honestly.
Show,
oh,
Taylor,
yeah, look at this.
Show Taylor my rug.
Look at this.
Look at,
this retro coolness.
Yep. And here's for Truly. House is not love without paw prints. Look at this one, Taylor. Kitty cats. Kitty cats. We can be just tacky all we want to.
Yeah. All right. So back to the food.
Back to the food. I'm not an interior decorator, in case y'all couldn't figure that out.
No, but it's cool stuff. Christine said, cute.
Thank you. All right, guys. So this is what we have tonight on the Spices Right. This is just some good old nostalgic comfort food that my husband wanted. This is American goulash, also known as chop suey. I don't know how, because I like chop suey. That ain't no chop suey, but
no.
This is American goulash. This is a wonderful bag o' salad with some avocado ranch and blue tortilla chips, and I added an egg for him and some bacon and some cheese. And then what did he want? He wanted just a piece of bread and butter.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, can you beat that with a stick? I don't think so.
I'm
and do you guys
I'm
think
I'm
going to
eat
cute?
It with a stick.
Look how cute my little Matt is. I love retro. I'm just such, I told Mark, I said, I cannot call myself retro. I think I'm an antique. Whatever. I like retro.
Taylor said she loves those rugs.
Thank you, and Taylor.
First Rick had to throw in Tennahoo.
Yeah, Tennahoo. That's right, Tennahoo. I think I meant Texas, and it just wasn't quite burnt enough.
Right.
Mark's shirt burnt orange.
So Andrew said, that's awesome. He said, I love the cats in space. Oh, so welcome, Savage. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Savage.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday All right. to you. All right. Happy birthday to Taste. You. Happy birthday, dear Savage. Happy birthday to you.
You should have sung it like Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, nobody wants to see that crap. Mm-hmm. That's some good stuff right there.
He said, thank you.
You're welcome, my friend. Thank you for awesome. Coming in here.
All right.
And thank you for sharing that country music lady to follow
Oh,
her.
Yes. Melissa loves her. So.
Oh, my goodness gracious. That is so good. All we need it is just not to be 95 degrees outside right now, and it is total comfort.
Yeah. Let me take a picture. Or did you?
No,
yeah,
I didn't.
Did you?
No. Here. Let's put this here so they don't see the bite.
Good thinking.
Mark's trying to get a picture.
All right, here we go.
Can't do this. Okay.
Okay.
Can you flip it so you can have a bite? I can't do the camera, guys. I am not the camera person. I'm right. just
there
the
we
cooker.
Go. Hey, everybody.
And a cooker. Okay. Right. Wait. How's that right?
Huh?
Okay. You want it like this?
Sure.
Okay. Well, that doesn't help me get it centered on you.
There. Everybody wants to see the food. Oh, man. This cheese is awesome. Sauce. It's very hot still, but it is awesome. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, delicious. Of course, I better we'll cool it down. That is awesome, everybody.
Oh, by the bread you had to have. He had to have a piece of bread with butter. I'm like, come on, I can do better than that. He goes, that's what I want.
I know, two or three.
Okay, you can have more.
I will be putting some of this right in here to get some juice. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm glad you like it, babe. All right.
Wonderful.
Ready? Are we ready to say almost goodnight? I think we're like 3 or 4 minutes short because we started a little bit late. But that's what we got. We got that. That's what we got. Look, Mark's got a burnt orange shirt on.
Trini's out of a 5-star meal.
Yay, guys. We love you.
Savage has a quick question before we go.
Yes, Savage, please.
American, is there a difference between American goulash and the other one that TikTok won't let me type?
That I don't know.
Was it maybe Hungarian, Savage? Because somebody actually mentioned that earlier.
Yeah, Benjamin, our newest creator on FoodtokTV, who's going to be on Thursdays, he is going to be Taylor's Thursday buddy. He'll be on at noon Central Standard Time starting this Thursday. He eats Hungarian goulash, which I've had. It has some.
He said yes.
It has some. The one that I've had has paprika in it. This one doesn't. This one does not. This is very, very simple and plain. It is on the FoodtokTV website. It is absolutely delicious. I use two different kinds of cheeses in it, and it is absolutely rib sticking. And let me tell you what I'm gonna eat for breakfast tomorrow. It's gonna be a bowl of that cold. I like it cold. So
perfect.
There's that.
Yep, and she will.
Anybody else?
If there's any left.
I love you too, Janine.
If there's any left,
Sherry, we'll see you at 7:30.
Yes. So thank y'all so much.
Y'all come play with Mark. Y'all come play with Mark. Let's go. We're gonna go. Oops, excuse us. We gotta do the puzzle.
There we go.
Yeah. Okay. Y'all come play under Mark Murdaugh. We're going to go play some games here shortly.
Janine said, love your food, Melissa.
Oh, thanks.
G said, there's a lot of Hungarian goulash dishes.
There are.
Absolutely.
Night, guys.
Night, guys. Night, thank y'all for coming in tonight. Yes. We appreciate all of you coming into FoodtokTV.
You're the best.
We love you guys. Thank y'all so much for your support. And we'll see y'all on FoodtokTV next Monday night.
Right. Here. And if you guys are not following FoodtokTV, give us a follow.
That's
We're
right.
always bringing in new creators. We're always having a good time and cooking it up. And just for a little extra for me. If you're not following Melissa Murd, that's me. Please do. MelissaMurd. Let's go.
She'll be back on a Wednesday night at 6 p.m. Central.
I sure will.
All right,
guys. We love you guys. Thanks so much for spending Monday night with us. Y'all have a blessed night.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.